Hi all, welcome to Tech Forum. In this video, let us explore various methods of web communication. In the dynamic world of web development, effective communication between different parts of a web application is crucial. Today, we will explore three popular techniques for achieving seamless communication. One is message channel, second one is broadcast channel, third one is window.postMessage. Window.postMessage. Window.postMessage is a JavaScript method enables communication between windows or iframes from different origin. This helps to build secure and collaborative web applications. This allows to send messages as data between different windows or iframes. These messages can be of various data types, including strings, objects, or even you can send structured data. When using window.postMessage, you specify the target window or iframe where the message would be sent. You can use window.parent to refer to the parent window or provide a reference to a specific window or iframe. Security. Messages can only be sent to windows or iframes from the same origin unless the target explicitly allows messages from other origins through the event listeners. Window.postMessage is used for scenarios like embedding third-party content securely within a website, also used for cross-document communication within a single website. Window.postMessage is supported by all major web browsers. Window.postMessage is often used for one-way communication, but you can implement two-way communication by enabling both the sender and receiver using window.postMessage and the event listeners. Ensure the best practices are followed while using the window.postMessage to avoid security vulnerabilities. Always validate and sanitize incoming messages. Verify the origin of the sender to ensure the messages are always coming from the known origin. If you see this diagram, we are using window.postMessage to communicate between parent window and the iframe. Here we are doing two-way communication, because both parent and iframe using postMessage and the event listener. The postMessage method has two parameters. The first one is message and the target origin. Star means the message can be dispatched to the event listener on any origin. Even you can specify specific origin, only to that origin the message should be dispatched. In this case, if the origin matches https://embed-demo.com, the message will be dispatched. The message listener listen for the incoming messages. Next one is message channel. Message channel JavaScript API facilitates the communication between different windows, iframes or workers, even if they are from different origin. It provides a secure and efficient way to exchange data and messages in a web application. With message channel, you can send messages and data between different windows, iframes or workers. These messages can include various data types such as strings, objects or more complex structured data. The message channel creates two message ports. One is called as port 1 and another one is port 2. One for sending and one for receiving the messages. These ports act as a dedicated communication channels between the two endpoints, allowing bidirectional data flow. The event listeners on the message ports need to be set up to receive the message. When a message is sent, the event handler function associated with the receiving port is triggered. The message channel API enforces the security measures for secure cross-origin communication. Message channel is optimized for efficient data transfers. That makes message channel suitable for scenarios where performance is critical, such as real-time applications or data-intensive processes. Message channel is commonly used for implementing features like cross-origin communications between different parts of a web application, improving the performance of web workers, and creating seamless interactions in multi-window or multi-iframe applications. Most of the modern web browsers supports the message channel API. That makes it a widely accessible solution for cross-origin communication. The message channel API inherently supports two-way communication. Each endpoint has its own message port, allowing both sending and receiving messages simultaneously. The message channel enhances security compared to some other communication methods, but still it's essential to validate and sanitize incoming messages and handles the errors appropriately for robust communication. If you see this diagram, we are communicating between parent window and a iframe. In parent context, we are first creating a message channel, then transferring channel.port2 to iframe, then through channel.port1 post messages to iframe. Also through channel.port1 on message event handler, receive messages from iframe. From iframe context, first receives port 2 from parent window. Then using port 2 post message to post messages to parent window. Also receive message from parent window through port 2 on message handler. Next one is broadcast channel. The broadcast channel JavaScript API enables communication between different windows, tabs, or iframes from the same origin. It allows you to broadcast messages to multiple recipients within the same origin context. With broadcast channel, you can broadcast messages as data to multiple windows, tabs, or iframes that share the same origin context. These messages can include various data types such as strings, objects, or structured data. When using broadcast channel, you create a named channel to which messages are broadcasted. Multiple instances of your web application can listen to messages on the same channel, providing a way to implement real-time updates or synchronization. To receive and handle messages sent via broadcast channel, you need to set up an event listeners for the specific channel. When a message is broadcasted on that channel, all listening instances trigger their event handlers. The broadcast channel enforces the same origin policy, ensuring that messages are only broadcasted and received within the same origin. This enhances security by preventing cross-origin communication. The broadcast channel is ideal for scenarios where you want to keep multiple tabs, windows, or iframes of your web application synchronized with each other, such as chat applications, collaborative tools, or real-time dashboards. Most modern web browsers supports the broadcast channel API. That makes it as a reliable choice for same origin communication. The broadcast channel is designed for one-to-many communication. You broadcast a message once and all listening instances within the same origin receive it. While broadcast channel simplifies same origin communication, ensure your application properly manages the channels and the event handlers to avoid message conflicts and leaks. If you see this diagram, we are using broadcast channel API to broadcast messages between different windows and tabs. Window 1 tab 1, window 1 tab 2, window 2 tab 1, window 2 and tab 2. In window 1 tab 1, so we are accessing test.html. So there we are creating new broadcast channel with the name channel test. Then through that channel, we can post messages. Also, we can receive messages through bc.onMessage. So the event listener, this on message triggers only if this window or tab is not the source or origin of the event. So now again same window 1 tab 2, we are again opening the same test.html, same things, new broadcast channel, same channel name, channel test. We can post message, we can also listen for messages. So then window 2 tab 1, we are accessing test.html from the same web application. So here also same, new broadcast channel, same channel name, channel test, post message and on message. Then window 2 tab 2, we are opening test1.html. Here again same, new broadcast channel, same name, channel test, but here only we are listening for the message, not posting the message. In summary, window.postMessage used for point-to-point communications can be used between two windows or iframes within the same origin or different origins with proper security measures. Message channel, suitable for bidirectional communication, works between closely related windows or iframes within the same origin or different origins with proper security measures. Broadcast channel, ideal for broadcasting messages to multiple subscribers, operates within the same origin only, allowing one sender to reach many recipients within that origin. Let us now see a quick demo. Windows.postMessage, I have a index.html that embeds embed.html through iframe. So here I am getting the reference to iframe, document.getElementById, my iframe, then message hello from parent, then iframe.contentWindow.postMessage, message and the target origin. As we discussed already, we can even specify star means any origin, but here I am saying only send it to this specific target origin. Also, I have a method to receive the message back from iframe. So if you see here, receive message from iframe, then I'm getting the event, then I am printing or alerting the event dot data. So technically I'm doing window dot add event listener, then message, then receive message from iframe. This is the handler. In embed.html, I have send message to parent method. So if you see here, message hello from the iframe. So here again, window.parent.postMessage, message, then I'm putting star here. Even you can specify the parent origin. So then receiving a message from parent. So again here, window.addEventListener, message, receive message from parent. This is the handler. So same thing, event.data, I'm just alerting that. So if you see here, I accessed index.html through siteademo.com DNS. So here, this is the index, post message index, send message to iframe. Also I embedded the iframe that has button send message to parent window. So let me click on this send message to iframe. So if you see here, an embedded page at embeddemo.com says received message from parent, hello from the parent. Technically this iframe received the message. Now if I go to embedded iframe, click on send message to parent window. So now siteademo.com says received message from iframe, hello from the iframe. Message channel API, I have a index.html that embeds embed.html through iframe, embeddemo.com embed.html. So if you see here, first creating a message channel, new message channel and channel, then set up message event listener on port 1 to handle incoming messages from iframe. Channel.port1.onMessage, then this is the event handler. So receiving the message from iframe or other windows, and we are printing it. Then if you see here, transfer port 2 to the iframe when it is ready. iframe.contentWindow.postMessage, port from iframe. I am specifying star, but we can specify specific origin, channel.port2. Now we can send the message. Here if you see, channel.port1.postMessage, whatever the message we want to send. If you refer embed.html, see here we have a event listener, window.addEventListener, message, then this is the handler. So if you see here, first we are getting the port. If the data is port for iframe, this is what we are sending from the parent, then we are getting that port e.ports0, then we are storing it to port 2. Then like here, if you see, we on port 2, we have a on message handler to receive the message from the parent. So then we are alerting whatever we are receiving. Also here we are sending back message through this port 2 dot post message, message back from iframe. This will be received by the parent window. Let me access index.html, siteademo.com. Let me refresh this page. If you see here, first received message from main page, hello from the main page. This iframe received this message. Click OK. Now received message from iframe, message back from the iframe. This main window, the parent window, received message from iframe. broadcast channel API, I have a index.html that embeds embed.html. If you see here, I embedded through two different options. One is iframe 1 src. I am using sitedemo.com. This is the same origin. I am going to access index.html. So the other one is https embeddemo.com embed.html. So as we discussed earlier, the broadcast channel won't support cross origin. The message will be delivered only when we use the same origin, sitedemo.com embed.html, not embeddemo.com embed.html. If you go to embed.html, see here, I am again broadcast channel, new broadcast channel, channel test, the same name what we used here as a channel name, channel test. Then listening to the messages, broadcast.onMessage, the event handler. Here I am again checking whether the message comes from index. If you require, you can filter it, or even you can receive all the messages. So then again broadcast.postMessage, I am posting message from here. Message iframe, because this is the message type I am setting. So then what is the message? Message, also the time, so to track it whether the same message is received. Then test.html, here again broadcast channel, I am creating the same broadcast channel with the same name, channel test. If you see here, I am only having broadcast.onMessage handler to receive messages, but I am not posting back any messages from here. So also I am only filtering this message from the index page. Okay, I have accessed sitedemo.com/index.html in this window. Then again same index.html in another tab. So then again test.html in another tab. Also I have another window opened, test.html. So now let me go and refresh this page. So if you see here, received message in index, hello from iframe. So if you see the time frame, that's what I was sending the time frame to match the messages, same message. So also broadcast demo, this is the iframe. If you see received message in iframe, hello from the index.html, same message. So now if I go back to this tab, again same message, received message in index, hello from the iframe. So received message in iframe, hello from the index.html. If I go to again test.html, so if you see the same message received from here, so hello from the index.html. Now if I go to another window, the same message inside test.html, hello from the index.html, same message received from here too. Even you can send message from here, maybe if you refresh this, again same thing, 402, yeah, it's received here. If you go here 402 and 402 over here also. The communication between different parts of the web application is critical to support various use cases. You can use post message or message channel or broadcast channel APIs based on your needs. I will post the link to the demo application to the video description. Thanks all for watching the video. See you all in the next video.